How's it going, everybody? Zoinkmeister Patrick here, back with some more Attack on Titan fan slash tribute game. Today I'll be showing off the races in the three main-ish Attack on Titan games. So that'll be Feng Lee's game, followed by Guedin's game, or however that's pronounced, and finally Roark's game. So if you're interested in any one of those specifically, you can go ahead and use that table of contents I put right at the beginning of the video. Just go there and pause and skip to it. Or I will put timestamps down in the description below. So if you just want to click on those, it'll take you right to where you want to go in the video. So besides that, you can see here that I'll be playing as Aaron Jaeger, just because the other two games you can only play as Aaron Jaeger. So a bit of a direct comparison. That being said, I'm not actually used to playing Aaron, especially not in the race. So I won't be able to do probably as well as I could with the character that I usually play, which is Levi, but I'll also be showing off my personal record in this particular game while playing as Levi at the end, if you're interested in that. So that being said, all three of the Attack on Titan games will be getting bonus videos. So this game will be showing off with Aaron, and its bonus will be showing off with Levi, and then I'll talk a bit more about the other bonuses for the other two games as we get to that part of the video. But example is in the Guedin race, I just want to do the two simple races to show off as far as comparisons are concerned. But then for a bonus, I'll show off one of the advanced, though I won't do as well, unfortunately, in that one. So you can see here, I am not quite up to, you know, a perfect run or anything like that. I will run into stuff, but this is a much longer race than the other two, so it's not really too surprising that, you know, a mistake is bound to happen here or there. This game's more designed around multiplayer, so it's sort of a long race for you to actually go up against other people, but whenever I go up online against other people, they always either do way better than me or way worse than me, so that's been exciting. This is my very average show off of the kinds of times I can get. So hope you enjoyed that. That's a 127.9 run, and we'll be moving on to the next game. That I think is an okay time for what I was hoping to show off. There's no A's or S, there's no ranks like this one has. So it's kind of hard for me to distinguish what is considered a good time or not. So I'm hoping that's a time there's a time I was happy with showing off. I think it showed the game off well enough. In such a long race, it's kind of hard to do repeated takes for. Here, however, I will be getting an S rank for Guedin's games, both of the Simple Race 1 and Simple Race 2, because it wasn't too much for me to do. I spent a bit of time making sure that I could get a good run, and you can see there, that's the first one already over. It's such a short race, it's a lot easier to keep doing until I manage to get that S rank to really show off what this game has to offer. And I think it has to offer a lot. This is a really cool game. The bonus video for this particular game, I show off one of the advanced races. I unfortunately can only manage to get an A time for the end point value for the advanced race, which is why I have it as a bonus. And if you want to get to any particular point in this video, if you're interested in only one of these three games, that's why I put that table of contents right there at the beginning. You can go to whichever part you like. So that's it for Guedin's game, and now we have Roark's game. This one I had a lot of trouble with. I actually spent two whole days just doing this race over and over again, just trial one, to try to get an S time for you guys. And unfortunately, I was never able to do it, get an S in both time and points. So this particular video, I get an A in points and a, sorry, I get an A in time and an S in points. And for the bonus video, which will come immediately after this one, I get an S in time, but only, I think, a B in points. So unfortunately I was not able to do both of those at the same time. So here is my S rank score. You can see here, but it's only an A rank in time, unfortunately. And then this video right now coming up is my S rank in time, but it's only B rank in score. You can see I don't do nearly as well as far as points go. So it was difficult for me to figure out how this game wanted me to play it. You see I use my split hooks here a lot, but since the split hooks just automatically go wherever they feel like going, a lot of times I had trouble getting consistent split hooks. So this game just doesn't feel like it's made for precision as much as these races want you to be precise. So I had a lot of trouble with them, but there you see I got a B for the score, but I did get an A for the time. And that was actually my personal record for time. So now we are back to the advanced Guedin race. I've actually gotten double S ranks on this before, but just not on camera. That was a little while back. So as far as recording went, I was only able to get double A ranks for the score and for the time, which is not the best. I know you can definitely see a lot of places where I'm not, you know, on the mark as much as I should be. But like even here, I just totally skipped this Titan. but I think it does at least show off kind of like what this game looks like in the advanced modes and what you can sort of do with it. So finally, we have here the Feng Lee. Aha, so I'm playing as Levi. This is my personal record. I'm so happy I managed to get it on camera. My heart was racing. I also drank too much caffeine that day, so who knows? I'm not commentating these live, if that wasn't obvious, because, well, they were very stressful and difficult to do and required a whole lot of retakes just to make sure I got the best video I could for you guys here on the channel. If you're interested in the Attack on Titan Titan modes, where you kill Titans, you can check out, we have a playlist on the channel where I do all of that. I'll make sure to put a link in the description. So if you want to see more Attack on Titan fan slash tribute game gameplay, go ahead and check out that playlist. And I think it'll have anything you could be looking for there. I kind of hope to do a little bit more with Attack on Titan in the future. But if you look at the upload dates for any of those videos, I do not upload very consistently at all. So do not, maybe don't expect too much of Attack on Titan out of me in the future, but please feel free to check out some of the other stuff we have on this channel. We're really passionate about video games, and so we do a lot of different kind of stuff. We don't really try to focus too much on any one particular game, but this is a game that I like, and I spent, these games are ones that I like and I've spent some time in, and so I did want to at least show off the race at some point, and so I finally got the chance to do that. I can even see here some of the places where, you know, this isn't a perfect run by any means, but definitely this was my proudest part of this video, is if you can get a straight run across here on the side, I love doing that. Yeah, you see I ran straight into a wall there, but yeah, I managed to get some speed. I don't know what I did this time versus some of the other times, but I am flying through this level. So some of the things you can do if you want to speed up is, you see I swing my blades every once in a while. That'll speed you up. I just don't do things consistently enough, honestly. This is a 111.7. That is a personal record for me. So I was pretty happy with it. But you can definitely get below 100. I've raced with people who got below 100. So if you like it, make sure to check out some of our other stuff. Zoink out.